Hello student, welcome back to the ADE session. This is Vasant Naik from Canara Engineering College. Today, in the last session, we have studied register and the data transfer between register. In this session, you will see shift registers. So, what is a shift register? Shift register is a register in which binary data can be stored and this data can be shifted to the left or right when shift signal is applied. Bit shifted out of one end of the register may be lost, or if the shift register is a cyclic type, then the data will be shifted back to the other end. So in the diagram, there are four types of shift registers are shown. One is serial in and serial out, second one is serial in and parallel out, third one is parallel in and serial out, and fourth one is parallel in and parallel out. So these are the four classification of the shift registers. One is called as CISO, SIPO, PISO and PIPO. In the first case, serial in and serial out, serial data is applied at the one end of the shift register. The other end of the shift register, serial data is shifted from one end to the other end. In the second case, serial in and parallel out, data is applied in the input data is given in terms of serial, but the output data will be taken like a parallel. So serial data will be given and parallel data will be taken out. Third one is the parallel in and serial out. Input is in the form of parallel data, then output is in the form of serial data. And the fourth one is parallel in and parallel out, that is input is in the form of parallel and output is also in the form of a parallel. So four types of shift registers. Now we will see how this works exactly. So here the diagram shows 4-bit shift register, serial in and serial out, that is input data is given in terms of serially and output data is taken like serially, 1-bit at a time, serial out is shown in the diagram. So here 4 flip-flops are connected and all the 4 flip-flops are driven by the single clock, that is also called a synchronous clock, and the clock signal is a positive edge trigger signal. Other than that, all the flip-flops are connected with the signal shift. When the shift is enabled, shift is 1, then it will enable all the flip-flops and the data will be shifted from the one end to the other end of the shift register. When shift is 0 here, then all the flip-flops will be disabled and whatever present data, that will remain as the output of the flip-flop. In other words, output of the flip-flop will not change, it will remain in the last state only. So here you can see like the input is given here and output is taken here. So if the flip-flop is a cyclic type, then the output can be fed back to the input once again. So here, this diagram shows the timing diagram of the shift register. So here in this timing diagram, so initially we will take the value. That is 1101. So here let me write the value. Value is 1101. When the shift signal is enabled, here you can see when the shift signal is enabled and during the positive edge trigger of the clock, this is the positive edge trigger of the clock. Now, during the positive edge trigger of the clock, this data will get shifted. So, output of the Q3 will be high, and this will remain high till the next clock edge arrives. At this time, At this time, here you can see, at time, let me mark here the time instant, something like this. This is T1, this is T2, this is T3. At time T2, you can see the data input is high. So output of the flip-flops remains high till the next clock edge arrives. At T3, data input is low. So output goes low after a small drip in the output. That is because of the propagation delay. Output goes low and it will remain low till the next clock edge arrives. During the next clock edge, that is at T4, input, that is data, is high. So once again Q3 output goes high. There's a small drift in the output with reference to the clock edge. That is because that is called as propagation delay or gate delay or switching delay. Now Q3 becomes the input for Q2. In the diagram you can see here, Q3, the output at Q3 becomes input at another flip-flop D2. So now to check the output of Q2, we have to see now what is the input at D2. The input at D2 is nothing but Q3. So with reference to Q3, initially Q2 is 1. Now during the negative edge of this during the clock edge, first edge of this clock, during the first edge of the clock here, output is low. So Q2 output goes low till the next clock edge. At this stage Q3 is high, that means Q2 will go high till the next clock edge. At this stage Q3 is high, so the output of the Q2 will go high till the next clock edge. At this stage, Q3 is low, output goes low. Similarly, for Q1, Q2 becomes the input at D1. So Q2 becomes the input. Initially, Q1 was 0. At the positive edge of the clock, Q2 is high. That means Q1 goes high till the next clock edge arrives. At the positive edge of the clock, Q2 is low, so Q1 goes low. At the next clock edge, at time T3, Q2 is high, that means output goes high. So now for the last flip-flop Q0, Q1 becomes the input at D0 and the output is as follows. So this is the timing diagram for 4-bit serial in and serial out shift register. This is the one more diagram which shows 8-bit serial in and serial out. Here SI is the serial in data and SO is the serial out data. It is constructed by using SR flip-flop. The first flip-flop, SR has got two input, S and set and reset. So this two input has been converted into one input by connecting a inverter in between S and R. This type of flip-flop are called as a D flip-flop. Here the input is given at the point SI. Now 8 flip-flops are connected as shown in the diagram and output is taken at 8th flip-flop. Now suppose with respect to the clock signal, this is the input data, in order to reach this data to the output, it requires 7 clock periods.
After 7 clock period, sir, this SI will be available at S0. After 7 clock period, this SI will be available at S0. Similarly, this data will be available after 7 clock period, sir. This is the disadvantage of this type of flip-flop, because it takes each clock cycle to transfer from one flip-flop to other flip-flop. Suppose if there are n flip-flops in the register, then it will take n minus 1 clock signals, clock cycles, to transfer the data from source to the from one end of the flip-flop to the other end, or one end of the register to the other end. So this is the major disadvantage of serial in and serial out. Here the diagram shows 4-bit parallel in and parallel out shift registers. That is, parallel in implies that all 4 bits can be loaded at the same time, and the parallel out implies that all the 4 bits can be read out at the same times. So this shift register has two control input. One is SH, shift enable. Second one is load enable. So these are the two control input, shift enable and load enable. Other than that, we have something called as negative triggered clock, and we have serial data. So if the SH is 1, shift enable is 1, and load signal is either 1 or 0, clocking the register causes the serial input to be shifted into the first flip-flop. While the data in the flip-flops Q3, Q2 and Q1 are shifted right. If SH is 0 and L is 1, the shift register will cause the 4 data inputs D3, D2, D1 and D0 to be loaded into the parallel into the flip-flops. If SH is equal to and SH is 0 and L is 0, clocking the shift register causes no change of the state. For example, here you can see here. So what I explained is if SH is 0 and L is 0, then there will be no change. If SH is 0 and L is 1, that will load the data into the register. If SH is 1 and L is 0 or 1, that causes the right shift. So three types of operations can be expected from here. One is no change. Second one is data will be loaded into the shift register. Third one is the right shift operation. The same thing can be implemented by here by multiplexer and D type of flip-flop. So here it is shown here. So we are using four D flip-flops, and these four D flip-flops are connected by means of 4:1 mux. 4:1 mux has got two control lines, that is, one is SH, second one is L. So depending on the control lines, whether 0, 0, the first combination is selected, 0, 1, second combination is selected, 1, 0 and 1, 1, third combination is selected. Here SH and L is given to the multiplexer as a control signal. So here you can see the output of the flip-flop is connected to 0, 0 combination. So when SH and L is 0, 0, then output remains the last state. When SH and L is 0, 1, the data will be loaded here. You can see D3, D2, D1, D0, data will be loaded into the flip-flop or register. When SH and L is either 1, 0 and 1, 1, SI will be loaded. Serial data will be loaded into the flip-flop. So some serial data will be loaded. The output of the second one is connected as serial data to the output of the first one is connected as serial data to the second one. Output of the second one is connected serial data to the third one. So output of the third one is connected to serial data for the fourth one. Like this, data will be shifted from the left to right. So by using this circuit diagram, you can implement three types of operations like 0, 0, 0, 1 and 1x. That is, the operations are no change, load and right shift. Dear students, now we will move to the last application of the shift register, that is ring counter and Johnson counter. Now what is a ring counter? This diagram shows the ring counter, 4-bit ring counter. Here 4 flip-flops are connected. Output of the last flip-flop is connected as a feedback to the input of the first one. So this is called a ring counter. Other than that, all the flip-flops are simultaneously driven by the clock signal, and other than that, we have asynchronous clear signal and asynchronous clear signal and asynchronous preset signal. For the first flip-flop, asynchronous preset signal is used, but for the rest of the flip-flops, asynchronous preset signals are not used. This is because, suppose if we assume that the output of all the flip-flops are 0, 0, 0, 0. After the first edge trigger of the clock, this output of the 0 will continuously rotate and continuously shift from the left to right and from the last to first in the ring format. So since output of all the flip-flops are 0, there won't be any change. In order to see the changes, what we do is we use the preset input and we will make the output of the first flip-flop as 1. Output of the first flip-flop as 1. So after the next clock pulse, output of the last will be moved to the first, output of the first will be shifted to the second, output of the second will be shifted to the third, output of the third will be shifted to the fourth. Once again, after the next clock pulse, output of the last will be shifted to the first, output of the first will be shifted to the second, output of the second will be shifted to the third, output of the third will be shifted to the fourth. In this way, you can see here, one will shift from one end to the other end in a ring format. This is the application of shift registers. So there are two applications of shift registers. One is called as a ring counter. Second one is called as a Johnson or tail counter. These are the application of the shift registers. So in the next slide, we'll see what is a Johnson or tail counter. So students, here you will see the diagram of Johnson or tail counter. So what is the difference between this diagram and Johnson or tail counter or ring counter? In the ring counter, you can see here the positive output of the last one is connected to the, as a feedback to the first one. So in the Johnson or tail counter, we are connecting the inverted output of the last one as a feedback to the first one. So this is the difference between the Johnson counter and ring counter. In ring counter, we will connect the positive output of the last one. We will connect the positive output of the last one to as a feedback to the input of the first one. In Johnson tail counter, we will connect the negated output of the last one as a feedback to the first one. So we will check this, how this works. Initially we will take this is the 3-bit ring count, Johnson tail counter. Initially we will take 0 0 0, that is, this is 0 0 0. When Q1 is 0, Q1 bar is 1, that is fed back to the first one. So during the next clock cycle, this becomes 1 0 0. Now once again, so now this becomes 1 0 0. Now Q1 is 0, Q1 bar is 1, so that is fed back to the first one. So and whatever there in the first one will be moved to the second one. So 1 1 0. Once again 1 1 1. So now negative of this one, I mean negation of this one, is fed back to the first one. So this becomes 0 1 1. Similarly 0 0 1, similarly 0 0 0. So this one is called as Johnson counter or switch tail counter or tail counter. This one is called as tail counter. This is one of the application of shift registers. This is one of the application of shift registers. This is called as a tail counter or Johnson counter. So with the students completed shift register, in the next session we will move to the counter. Thank you.